Hello and welcome along to the Excelsior Stadium in Airdrie. It is the UEFA Women's Champions League. We're at the round of 32 stage and it's the second leg of this Champions League tie. It's Glasgow City against Medyk Konin, and the visiting side today, well, they created a bit of a shock in terms of the coefficients. They won in Poland by 2-0. A tie which some feel may well be over, including the Polish players at full time, but not, I'm going to tell you, like a market, according to Glasgow City and the home fans who have turned up in numbers at Excelsior Stadium. It should be an exciting contest and hopefully a game for the home side which will be memorable to maybe take them into the last 16 of the UEFA Women's Champions League. Looking at the starting lineups for Glasgow City, one change for the team that started last week. There were a number of changes at the weekend, but compared to last Wednesday, one change. Laura Murchery is out of the squad altogether. Abby Grant comes into the starting 11. And for Medyk Konin, an unchanged lineup, the same 11 that won the game in Poland, including 17-year-old Ian Pajor, who is a goal scoring machine this season in the Champions League with 8 goals. A tremendous noise around the Excelsior Stadium. Hoping to potentially get up to maybe 4 figures here at the Excelsior. The flags are out, the teams are coming out. The referee this evening is Anastasia Pustovodota from Russia, and she is in charge alongside Ekaterina Kupchenka from Russia, Sabina Valeva, and the 4 officials, Erin Cunningham from Scotland. As the Champions League anthem plays, the famous Champions League anthem, a big job for Glasgow City this evening, but a job that is winnable. We're getting ready for kickoff in this UEFA Women's Champions League match, and off we go then, and Medyk Konin gets underway from left to right. As I said, they're going from right to left in this first half at the Excelsior Stadium. And thank you very much for joining us if you're on live streaming. Ewa Pajor's in early on here, and the ball came through, and what an early fright for the Glasgow City defence. Owen Nelson's played that over the top of the Alexander, and McSorley back in the air to clear away. It was just a hopeful little ball over the top. Love and Brown over the ball. There's Joe Love's delivery. Lappin's there, and McSorley has put it wide. That looked like it was a tap-in for Ellis McSorley, but just skimmed away past that left-hand post. Sakura picks up that right to Garanska. Doherty trying to catch. Still Garanska tries to get round and does get round. Doherty cuts across and stabbed away by McSorley. Fiona Brown's corner. Lapping with a little header. It's hacked away off the line. Still bombing around. Nelson's there. And this time they'll be able to clear it away on this near hand side. Brown in company. Doherty's maybe wanting it back. Fiona Brown tries to cut inside to Sakura. Comes back centrally to Love. Lapping, Marlborough trying to link up. O'Sullivan's chasing hard up against Herzegovina Malton. It kind of just left it to run to the goalkeeper. It did. It's Joe Love's full delivery. And it's straight into the grateful hands of Anna Szymanska. Black skims it across. O'Sullivan. Fairly trying to get in behind. O'Sullivan's bobbling around. Still O'Sullivan in the box. Looking to turn. And Lappin! She was nearly off celebrating. Fabulous save by Szymanska. She was nearly running away. Lappin. O'Sullivan. Lappin. Good play. It's Joe Love on the edge of the box. Lappin with a little flick. O'Sullivan, Fiona Brown! Oh, and just looking for something to get something on it, somebody to get something on it. Doherty, another wing. Brown. Up against Zigic, gets round Zigic, it's Brown. O'Sullivan coming towards the back stick, fairly there, and Slavcheva away off the line. Sorley, out to the left with Brown. Brown getting past Kuzminska. Fiona Brown motor in. Oh, and I think it might have clipped the right hand post there. Inside of the goal area. Doherty onto Brown on the left. Brown. Owen tipped over by Szymanska. I don't think Szymanska was sure. Edging further forward. Brown picks up really well here in behind Brown. Marlborough on the edge of the box, leaves it for a Sullivan, and Joe Love deflected and in! It's a goal! Glasgow City are back in the tie! Joe Love with the goal! And it's a huge lifeline! 13 minutes into the second half, and Joe Love scores a 14th goal of the season, and oh, it could be so crucial! Roman Justicak, the Medyk Konin coach, will be worried on the bench. Marlborough on the turn in the box here, and Fairley, it's a clipped hand, and just enough for Wanda Szymanska. Still danger on this other side now from the throw. Shield the ball, Doherty, it's a good ball across, and Fairley, goodness me, Szymanska had pretty much all of her body over that ball on the line and keeps hold of it. Does really well to get past Twizjak. Decent ball across, and Konat was there to head away. Doherty floats it back across in, and Fairley offside, is he? No! It's in! It's the equaliser on aggregate! We are all level! 2-0 on the night, and with 14 minutes to go at the normal time, we are all level, and come back accomplished. Will they go on now and get a winner in normal time? But it is all level at 2-2 in aggregate, 2-0 tonight. It's given away though by Nelson, and Pajot is in behind here, and it's a great ball across, and what a save from Lee Alexander from Goranska. The captain had the chance to win it, and game. They've got the throw on halfway in the final few seconds of stoppage time. Fact that that is the end of stoppage time, and Glasgow City have done the job to get back level in the tie after 90 minutes. We are going to extra time. Fiona Brown on the left hand side with an important delivery in the opening 3.5 minutes of extra time. There's Brown's delivery, lovely header, it's cleared, it's in, it's O'Sullivan! Denise O'Sullivan! It's Glasgow City in the lead in the tie for the first time! Current top goal scorer, now 19 goals this season, but that may well be the most important. Lisa Sullivan, 3-2 on aggregate. Well out, Glasgow City are in charge for the first time in the tie. It's given away here, and O'Sullivan's profited. Plays it across Marlborough. Brown! And that may well finish it off, but blasting over. If this goes in, that pretty much is it. It's 3-2 in aggregate to Glasgow City. 3-0 in the night. The free kick comes into the hands of Lee Alexander. And is that the last chance for Medyk Konin? Under the head of O'Sullivan. Lapin. Sullivan giving the player of the match award. And it's over. Mission accomplished. It wasn't the pretty way, but they came from 2-0 down, and they've won the last 32 tie. It's only the last 32, but incredible performance. And after all the celebrations from Medyk Konin last week, there's tears from them in Airdrie as Glasgow City are through to the last 16, and all probability are up against Zurich of Switzerland. It's Swiss delight for Glasgow City. They're into the next round of the UEFA Women's Champions League. They're into the last 16 again. An incredible performance. And they got going with Joe Love on the hour mark after one or two shaky moments. Joe Love got the goal scoring underway on the hour mark. Susan Fairley was left in the acre of the space, and we get to 11 minutes later. And then that went to extra time. They got themselves back on level on aggregate. And then they got the crucial goal. Denise O'Sullivan, 19th of the season, and probably the most crucial goal for Glasgow City this season. And there was still one or two scary moments in defence in extra time. But Emma Black, who's captain tonight, seen her side through, and the job is done, albeit the very hard way after losing last week. Eddie Lake is back through to the last 16 of the UEFA Women's Champions League. Domestically, it's the semi-final of the Cup this weekend. All eyes on that, I'm sure, maybe tomorrow after the celebrations tonight. But final score from the Excelsior Stadium, Glasgow City 3, Medyk Konin 0, and aggregate Glasgow City go through by 3-2.